Well, hello there, I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my 48th video here at EatTheWeeds.com. Today I'm going to talk about the Serranoa repens, or the saw palmetto. It's a plant with a 400-year history and very modern application, so let's go take a look at it.
And what you're looking at here is a Serranoa repens, a saw palmetto. And the saw palmetto has three claims to edible fame, but the first one we're going to look at is right here, these little black olive-looking type berries. So we'll get to them in a minute. Also, these fronds, if you pull a frond out, the little, about 1/2 inch to 1 inch at the end, is quite nutty and edible. Also, this plant is something like a hydra. It has many, many heads, and if you cut off one, you can get to what's called the heart of palm inside and not kill the tree, or not kill the bush. So you can get three edible things off this plant at one time. You can get the saw palmetto berries, you can pull the fronds out and get a very nice trailside nibble there, although I have to be careful because the fronds are covered with little spikes, so you have to pull them out carefully. And you can go right to about here, cut this off, take it out, and the center core is very, very tasty. And it doesn't kill the tree. Sorry, kill the plant. Kill the palm. Now, let's see if I can just pick a few of these. Oops, one fell down on me there. There we go. We'll probably take these home and take a good picture of them. There we are. Let's see what they look like here.
You can see, they do indeed resemble olives.
So let's talk about that. These berries have become a multi-million dollar industry of late. They're dried and powdered and used to treat benign prostate problems and prevent enlargement of prostates and things like that. In fact, it's a $70 million industry here in the state of Florida. And they even had to pass a law to keep people from going on private property and stealing these little things. Well, they're not so little. As you can see, they're about the size of olives. By the way, if you do take saw palmetto berries for prostate problems, you should know that it can skew your PSA test and make it appear things appear better than they are. So if you are taking these things and you do take a PSA test, make sure you tell your doctor that.
There's quite a story that is attached to the saw palmetto, and it goes back to 1696, and I think you ought to know about it. Back then, a fellow named Jonathan Dickerson was traveling from Jamaica to Philadelphia. He was on a barkentine, which is a small ship about the size of two or three cars, and he and his party ran into a hurricane off the southern tip of Florida. They were driven ashore at where Jupiter Inlet is now, and in fact, there's now a state park called the Jonathan Dickerson State Park. Well, you know, the captain of the ship broke his leg when the mast came off, and there were several injuries, and he had an infant son that wasn't eating, and they were captured by the Indians, and Dickerson was taken before the chief of the Indians, and while he was there, a big basket of these saw palmetto berries were brought in and put down in front of him, and Dickerson said the Indian chief ate of them greedily. Greedily. Well, Dickerson and his party had this huge problem. They thought the Indians were cannibals. So they didn't want to eat. You know, you don't want to look too edible to a cannibal. But the Indian chief kept trying to feed them. But after a while, the party decided that they had to eat. And so they had this basket of saw palmetto berries again. And Dickerson tried them, and he said, none of us, despite the fact that we were nearly starving to death, could eat these saw palmetto berries. And he had a description of them. He said they tasted like rotten cheese seeped in tobacco juice. Okay, well, I'll get back to that in a moment. But hear the rest of Dickerson's story. The Indians finally let them go after a couple of months, and they walked the entire distance from southern Florida to northern Florida on the beach, pulling rowboats with some injured in them. No food, no water, in the heat of summer. Halfway up the state, they ran into a second hurricane and were captured a second time by Indians. Let go again, they finally made it to St. Augustine, but they got a bad reception there because they were English, and St. Augustine was in Spanish control then. And five of them died. But eventually, Dickerson made it to Philadelphia, became mayor twice, and wrote a book about the exploits, which was published several times over the next century or centuries in many languages. What I find disquieting about the entire story is that, not the story, but the what people write about it, they call Dickinson a traveler. And they say his reference to the rotten cheese soaked in tobacco juice is humorous. Well, no, actually, it wasn't humorous. And I can't imagine having to walk several hundred miles on a Florida beach with no food or water, pulling your engine in rowboats, and being captured in a hurricane. So it wasn't a humorous time. However, let's go back to his description. You know, when I was about 10, I stole some plug tobacco and tried chewing it. And it was awful. Now, Dickinson's description of these saw palmetto berries, that they taste like rotten cheese soaked in tobacco juice, is actually pretty accurate. To the modern palate, these taste like extremely intense, oily blue cheese with a huge amount of pepper tossed in. Now, try eating that. Now, they're not all as bad as they sound. As a matter of fact, I have one right here, and probably be the first person on camera on Earth to eat one of these, since Dickinson described them. They're not bad if you take just a little bit at a time. Their flavor is sweet. It's almost intensely sweet. And it does really taste like a sweet blue cheese, but there's an oil factor that kind of goes all the way around your mouth. It lasts quite a while. They're not too bad. But then the pepper part kicks in and gives you a punch. But there's a bit of you can eat these. Here's proof. But you know what? I think I would eat one at a time, and I would try just a little bit at a time, particularly if you're not used to these. I'm used to them, and I'm still eating it slowly. But they're also extremely nutritious. They've got a high amount of fat in them, and as a matter of fact, Dickinson's infant son refused to nurse, and they eventually fed him on a mixture of saw palmetto berries and other things, and he survived. So these are tasty. Well, yes, they are. It grows on you, but try them carefully at first. Saw palmetto, Serenora repens. There we go. Well, we itemize here on EatTheWeeds.com, so let's itemize the saw palmetto, starting with identification. Well, they're a low palm, very sprawling. They're hydra, meaning they got many heads, and the leaves are palmate. Palmate, like palm. The stalks have saw-like teeth on them, hence they're called saw palmetto, and palmetto means little palm. The fruits look like black olives. They're green, turning to black, and it has a large seed, but do not eat the seed. Time of year. The tips of the stalks are edible year-round, as is the heart of the palm. The fruits, however, ripen in September and October. Environment. Well, that's pretty easy. No, they like it hot, sunny, and dry. But they will respond to irrigation, so they will grow well if you water them a little. And they grow from the Carolinas out to Texas and south. Method of preparation. The tips of the stalks that you pull out can be eaten raw. There's only about a half inch there, an inch. The heart of the palm can be eaten raw or cooked. It tastes like cabbage when you cook it. And the fruits, the berries, you can eat them when they're ripe, when they're raw, or you can dry them. Now, I want you to be careful. When you pull out the stalk, it does have little saw teeth on there, and you need protection on your hands because you don't pull it steadily. You have to give it a good jerk, and you get about an inch worth of eat. But it can really cut your hands if you don't do it right, so wear protection. Thank you for joining me here in my 48th video of EatTheWeeds.com, and I'm talking about the saw palmetto. Now, if you go to my website, you can read about the saw palmetto and about 120 other edible plants. So until next time, I'm Green Deane. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, and sometimes that includes black olive-like berries from the saw palmetto that taste like extremely intense blue cheese with a pepper afterburner. And they smell that way too. Toodles.